Now let's see about cache memory. First let's see about the characteristics of cache memory. Cache memory is extremely faster memory. That is, access time is very, very speed. It is very, very faster. As well as cache memory is very, very expensive memory. And one more important characteristics of the cache memory is it is very, very small in size. So cache memory can store only KB of instructions. Now let's see the advantage of the cache memory. Generally, if you take any program, then a certain set of the instructions are to be executed repeatedly, frequently, and the remaining instructions are executed only once. Let us assume that we have a program which contains for loop. So that for loop will be executed several times, whereas the remaining statements are to be executed only once. Let us assume that we have a program which contains function calls. We know the advantage of the functions. Functions are mainly useful for reusability purpose. So that means if we want to execute a set of statements repeatedly, then only we use the function. So that means here we may call that function several times. So that function call will be executed several times, and the remaining statements are to be executed only once. So here the point is, if a program contains some looping control statements or function calls, then those statements are to be executed very frequently, very repeatedly, and remaining set of statements are executed less frequently. They may be executed only once. This property is called as locality of reference. Locality of reference. So locality of reference states that a certain set of statements are to be executed very frequently, and the remaining statements are executed less frequently. So now with the help of the cache memory, what we can do is, if we place those active instructions, those frequently used instructions, those repeatedly accessed instructions in the cache memory, so if we place those frequently accessed instructions in the cache memory, then the total execution time of the program will be reduced. That is, the average memory access time will be reduced. Why? Because the advantage of the cache memory is cache memory access time is extremely faster than main memory access time. So CPU can access the content of the cache memory very, very fastly. So that the total execution time of the program will be reduced, as well as the total average memory access time will also be reduced. So that is the advantage of the cache memory. So that's why we have to place the cache memory in between CPU and main memory. So whenever CPU needs to execute an instruction or a word, then first it checks whether that word is present in cache memory or not. Suppose if the word is present in cache memory, then CPU accesses that word and executes that word. Suppose if the word is not found in the cache, then CPU accesses the main memory. So from the main memory, that word will be transferred to the cache memory. So now CPU accesses the cache memory to execute that word. Okay. Here we can analyze the performance of the cache memory by using hit ratio. Here we have hit and ratio. Hit ratio. We can calculate hit ratio with the help of the formula called number of hits by hits and misses. Hits and misses. So this is the formula for hit ratio. Hit means whenever CPU needs to execute a word, it checks whether that word is present in the cache or not. Suppose if the word is present in the cache, then it is called as hit. Suppose if the word is not present in the cache, then CPU access the main memory. So if the word is not present in the cache, then it is called as miss. Okay, so that word should be transferred from main memory to the cache memory. So CPU access that word. Okay, so the formula here is, the formula for hit ratio is number of hits by number of hits plus number of misses. So as a user, as a developer, our target should be hit ratio will be very, very high. So hit ratio will be very, very high, means most of the time CPU is accessing cache memory instead of main memory, so that with less amount of time we can execute the program. Here, if the board is not present in the cache, then the corresponding board should be transferred from main memory to the main memory to the cache memory. So how the transformation will be done? So that should be done with the help of mapping. So mapping is a process by using which the corresponding board will be transferred from main memory to the cache memory. Here mainly there are three types of mappings are available. The first one is associative mapping, second one is direct mapping, third one is set associative mapping. Associative mapping, direct mapping, set associative mapping. So by using mapping, we can transfer the word from main memory to the cache memory. So first let's see about associative mapping. Why this is named as associative mapping means, here we are in order to implement the cache, we are using some associative memory here. Here CPU generated an address here. Here the address size is 15 bits here. Here the size of the main memory is 32k words. Let the size of the main memory is 32k words, where each word store 12 bits of information. Here 32k means, 32 means 2 power 5. 1 kilobyte is nothing but 2 power 10. So 2 power 5 into 2 power 10 is nothing but 2 power 15. So here the CPU address size is 15 bits, where each word contains how many bits? 12 bits. Okay. So the data size is 12 bits. So address size is 15 bits, whereas data size is 12 bits. So out of those 32k words, cache memory can store, at a time it can store 512 words, where each word size is 12 bits. Okay. Here CPU generated an address. Address size is 15 bits. That corresponding address will be stored in argument register. Then the address of the argument register will be compared with cache memory. So this is nothing but associative memory cache. Okay. Associative mapping cache. Associative mapping cache. Okay. Here with the help of this memory, we are storing three words here. Okay. Where we know that each word address size is 15 bits. Here we are using octal notation. Octal notation means each digit represents three bits. Each digit represents 3 bits of information. So here totally we have 5 digits are there. So 5 into 3. So that is nothing but 15 bits. Here data size is what? 12 bits. 4 digits. So 4 digit means 1 digit is equal to 3 bits of information. Octal representation. 4 to 1. So 4 into 3 means 12 bits. Okay. So here the address of the argument register will be compared with address of this associative mapping cache. Let us assume that this is the corresponding address. So this word will be delivered to the cache. So cache memory will execute the word. So totally there are three words are there here. This is nothing but address of each word. This is nothing but data. So first word address, first word data. Second word address, second word data. Third word address, third word data, like that. Let CPU generated an address called 22345. So here we have 22345. So this 22345 will be compared with all the addresses. So here a match is found. So this word is delivered to the CPU. So CPU executes that word. Suppose if the corresponding word is not present in the cache, then that word will be transferred from main memory to the cache memory. Let us assume that cache memory is completely full. Why? Because at a time the cache memory can store only 512 words only. Let us assume that cache memory is completely full. Then we have to replace one of the word in the cache memory to store new word from the main memory. So which word we have to replace? That depends upon the replacement algorithm we use. We have FIFO algorithm, OPT algorithm, LRU algorithm. So depends upon the replacement algorithm, we will replace the corresponding word. Now let's see about direct mapping. In direct mapping, what will happen is that the CPU generated address is divided into two parts. The first part is tag address. The second part is index address. Here the size of the tag is 6 bits. So 6 bits means we need 2 digits for representing the data. And the size of the index is 9 bits. So 9 bits means we require 3 digits in order to represent that index address. So here we have main memory and here we have cache memory. So these are nothing but main memory addresses and these are nothing but main memory data. So 00000 is nothing but address. 1220 is nothing but data. So 5 digits, 4 digits. So 5 into 3 means 15 bits, 4 into 3 means 12 bits. 00777 means address, this is the data. So likewise, we have taken some data in the main memory, and this is nothing but the cache memory. In the cache memory, this is nothing but index address. For representing the index address size is 9 bits. 9 bits means we require 3 digits. So 000 is nothing but those 3 digits. Next 777 is nothing but those 3 digits. Here tag means 6 bits. 6 bits means we require 2 digits. So 00 is nothing but those 2 digits. 1220 means what? Data. Here 000000 means in 000000 first 2 zeros are nothing but tag. Next 3 zeros are nothing but index. 1220 is nothing but data. In 02777, this 02 is nothing but tag 777. So the last 3 digits are useful in order to access the index of the cache memory. Okay. So 6710 is nothing but data of the corresponding word. Okay. Let us assume that CPU generated an address called 02777. So then here this index address is useful in order to access the cache memory. So where the 777 is there in the cache memory? So this is nothing but the 777. Then after that we have to check whether 02 is tag or not. So we have to compare the CPU generated tag address with the cache memory tag address. If these two are same, then this word cache memory will allocate this word to the CPU. So CPU executes this word. The major problem with this approach is if two or more words with same index address but with different tags are accessed repeatedly, then hit ratio performance will decrease drastically. Let us assume that I want to access 01777. So in this, what is the index address? 777 is the index address. So this 777 is useful in order to access the cache memory. But here, what is the tag here? 01. But here, what is the tag here? 02. So these two are not matching here. Why? Because here the problem is in an index address, it is not possible to store multiple tags. So multiple words are not stored here. Let us assume that we have one more request, 04777. So 777 is the index address, but 02204, these two are not matched. So what is happening here? Several times misses are there. So if there is a miss, then what we have to do? That word is not present in the cache. So that word should be transferred from main memory to the cache memory. So several times we are transferring the data from main memory to the cache memory. So the performance of the hit ratio will decrease drastically. We can overcome this problem with the help of set associative mapping. The major advantage of the set associative mapping is in a single index, we can store multiple words. So this is the first word here. So if we want, we can store second word also here. This is nothing but second word tag. So second word data. Okay. Let here the second word tag is second word. This is nothing but here. What is the tag? 00 is the tag here. Let here the tag is 01. Let the data is 1234. So likewise here also. So in each index address, we can store multiple tags, multiple words. So let here the tag is 04 and the word is 4567. So let us assume that we want to access this address 04777. So this index address is useful in order to access the cache memory. So this 777 is useful. Next, what is the tag here? 04. Here we don't have 02, but here we have 04. So search is found, match is found. So cache memory will allocate this word to the CPU. So CPU executes that word. So the major advantage of the set associative when compared with the direct mapping is, in direct mapping, in each index address we can store only one tag. That means each index address can store only one word only. Whereas with the help of set associative mapping, at each index address we can store multiple tags. So this is about what is cache memory and what are the various mapping functions. So totally there are 3 mapping functions. Direct associative mapping. Associative mapping is very, very expensive. We will discuss more about associative memory in the future videos. Associative mapping is very, very expensive. We can overcome that problem with direct mapping. But the problem with direct mapping is each index address can store only one tag. So there is a possibility that hit ratio may decrease drastically. So we can overcome that problem with the help of set associative mapping.